Hello everyone, how are you? Hope you are doing well. After watching this video, you will be able to understand what is SAAS model and cloud model, an introduction to mastery, and what are the systems involved in SAP SuccessFactors. I would recommend you to watch this video till the end, and the people who are new in this domain can get the maximum benefit by understanding the core concepts of SAP SuccessFactors. Do remember to share the video with others who want to enhance their knowledge in SAP SuccessFactors. If you are new here, please consider to subscribe our channel down below and hit the bell icon to get any future updates. Now let's get started. First, take a look what is Introduction to Mastery. It involves the basic building blocks of SAP SuccessFactors for every module used in SAP SuccessFactors. List are the modules of SAP SuccessFactors in which Employee Central, PMGM and RCM are the most demanding and having more career opportunities all over the globe and are mainly used under the SAP SuccessFactors. All SuccessFactors modules are integrated with each other that we don't require any kind of external integration between these modules like we have to do in SAP S/4HANA. For example, if we have to transfer cost center from CO to HCM, first we have to integrate both of the system, CO and HCM. As you can see, some SuccessFactors modules, Employee Central Core, PMGM, RCM, Succession Planning, Recruitment Marketing, Compensation Management, Workforce Analytics and Planning, and GEM Social Collaboration. Now, Employee Central basically supports a very good feature called MDF Metadata Framework, which is inbuilt feature of Employee Central. It provides customization according to customer needs by building new screens, custom fields, and custom objects. Here you can create multiple custom objects depending upon the customer needs. Now, what is SuccessFactors? SuccessFactors basically a cloud-based HR solution in which it is going to help organization in executing all the HR activities like right from hiring the employees followed by the process of annual increments, performance, salary correction, termination of the employees from the promotion, etc. We can do all the HR activities in a digitalized way. SuccessFactors has an advantage over legacy system HCM that in HCM we require a wrapper for customization, tables and reports, and in here in SF we don't require any wrapper to do the customization. Only the functional consultant can do himself all the customization. Here SAP SuccessFactors offer two solutions. One is a standalone solution and the other one is hybrid solution. In a standalone solution you can use SF suite with EC with talent modules like PMGM, RCM with having no dependencies on the old system. But in hybrid solution, we don't use EC core. Here we will use SuccessFactors talent modules like PMGM, RCM with legacy HR system like HCM, Workday or any other third party system. Today what we use everything like social media, Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, all our cloud based applications. In a similar way, we host our employee data in SAP SuccessFactors and accessing the data on demand whenever we required. This way of accessing our data is called as cloud model or technically called as SaaS software as a service model. Now what is SaaS model? Here SuccessFactors will be used software as a service on demand. So this way of accessing the system and accessing the data with just an internet connectivity, you don't have the database, physical database in your office, in your location. So this is all remote process which is called as SaaS software as a service based platform, technically called as cloud platform. These remote locations where SAP hosted customer database stored are also called as data centers. In these data centers, customer servers hosted. Today SAP operating 15 data centers across the globe. One is in Australia, second one is in Saudi Arabia, third one is in Singapore, fourth and fifth one are in America. Advantages of SaaS cloud model. There is no hardware or maintenance required, so the first commercial benefit we are getting on the cloud solution, that is the customer will see that it will reduce the low total ownership cost. The second advantage is license model. It is user-based license. SuccessFactors is all user-based subscription. We only require license for the people who work in the system. The next advantage is release management, means it will release on every 6 months. They come up with latest functionality and regular updates, releases, bug fixes and enhancements. The next advantage of SuccessFactors is accessibility. SuccessFactors can be accessed from anywhere, anytime and any place around the globe. System architecture. SuccessFactors system divides into two parts, provisioning system and instance system. Provisioning system is backend of SuccessFactors. Here we will do 15% of activation. Provisioning is a place where you do some basic activations and needs to be done whenever you start your project in a real time. First, there are some basic activation needs to be done, then you will be able to do configuration. Only as a certified consultant will be able to do activation in provisioning system. Activation means enabling the backend switches. Without the activation from the provisioning, you will not be able to do configuration in instance system. The activations you will do in provisioning are language packs, module specific activations like EC, PMGM, RCM, role based permissions, profile V12, and upload data models. The next is instance front end of SuccessFactors system. Here we will do 85% of the configuration. Majority of your project business configuration, workflows, logics, and validation, everything is on the instance side. Here we have end user access and admin access. Next is we have system overview. In the user access, we have a user that we create from provisioning, which is super admin, which have all the permission to access the system. Next is employee file. Employee file hold all the records of the employees like personal information, address, salary details, dependents, each and everything about the employee that employee file holds. The next thing is org chart. Org chart represents the hierarchy of an employee in an organization right from CEO till the bottom of an employee. It gives the snapshots of the employee's details. The last thing is admin center. Admin center is the place location where all the modules configuration happen. Now I want to elaborate this thing from the system. When you log in into the SuccessFactors system, here you will see the home button. Click on home button and at the bottom you will see org chart. Click on org chart. Here on org chart we have a user LXC. Here if you will click on one level up, it will go to his supervisor, and again when we will click on one level up, it will come to the CEO. We have employee hierarchy can be seen. As you can see, Mohan Kumar has four subordinates. These four persons are reporting to Mohan Kumar. And we have another employee named Audrey Akin. She has six subordinates under him, and these six people are reporting to Audrey Akin. The employees, the entire employee structure from right from top CEO till the bottom of the employee can be seen in org chart. Now the next thing we have is admin center. And in admin center, we have tools, admin alerts looking for help. In tools, when you select on see all, you can see all the modules related configurations are done in admin center. Like we have 360 review, company settings, compensation, development, employee file, foundation object configuration, all object configuration are done in under admin center. The next thing we have is employee file. In employee file, we have different kinds of portlets. Here you can see, and in section we have subsections, and in subsections we have portlets. For example, in section employee information, we have subsection of employee detail, and in employee detail, we have a portlet named employment details. Here you can see the hire date of an employee, seniority start date, contingent worker. The next is organizational information. In an organization information, we have a portlet called position information, organizational information. All of the information related to employee are stored in employee file. If you have any query, you can comment below. I will surely clear you. Thank you. Have a great day.